Well, a very warm welcome to everyone gathered here at St. George's Church tonight. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ and family and friends, may God's love and blessing be with you. Welcome to this service of nine lessons and carols. So please let us now rise as we begin our worship by listening to the first stanza of Once in Royal David's City. Then we can join in the singing. Let us rise.
Standing as we pray the
bidding prayer. Dear Church of Christ and all friends and guests with us here today, we come to worship and honor Christ Jesus in remembrance of his birth as a human being on earth. Let our hearts be filled with great joy and celebration to hear again the angels sing. Let us in the journey of our hearts go to Bethlehem to meet him who is Lord and God, who came to us as a babe born in a manger. Let us listen to the Holy Scriptures that reveals to us the loving purpose of God to save us by this holy child from our fall into sin and disobedience. Let us, as the parish of St. George's, we've all gathered here today, deeply praise him and greatly rejoice in his love from our hearts. Let us lift up to you now, O Lord, the many needs of humankind and of this world that you alone can meet. Praise you, Lord, and thank you for extending to us all your peace and goodwill, for unity and brotherhood in the Church Universal that is your people. We pray for our nation, Singapore, where we are now gathered, the President and Prime Minister of this land. We pray for the Diocese of Singapore, the Church in this nation, and for all the churches and nations represented by all gathered here today, that we may receive from you your most gracious blessing of goodness and salvation. We earnestly seek of you now in Christ's name that you extend your great love and compassion to the poor and the helpless, the cold and the hungry, the oppressed and the imprisoned, the sick in mind and body, the mourners and the bereaved, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the newborn, even all who know you not or love you not, and those who have grieved your heart of love by sin, that your boundless compassion continue to minister to them and draw them to your salvation. We remember before you, Father, all the faithful who have finished their walk on earth, who stand with you in eternity beyond death, who rejoice with us, whose hope, like ours, is in the Word made flesh, that they join with us as one now and forever to pray to you in Jesus' name. We humbly offer up these prayers and praise to you, Father, in your heavenly throne, and continue to pray with the words which Christ himself had taught us in the Lord's Prayer. You can find this at the bottom of page 2. Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated at this time.
Amen. God announces in the Garden of Eden that the seed of woman shall bruise the serpent's head. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked. So I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all the livestock and all the wild animals. You will crawl on your belly and you will eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head and you will strike his heel."
Thank you. God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall the nations of the earth be blessed. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven a second time and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand on the seashore. Your descendants will take possession of the cities of their enemies, and through your offspring, all nations on earth will be blessed because you have obeyed me.
Thank you. Christ's birth and kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
The peace that Christ will bring is foreshown. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of power, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling together. And a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together. And the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra. And the young child put his hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him, and his place of rest will be glorious.
Oh, the angel Gabriel salutes the Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." And then the angel left her.